We have serious issues in our nation today. And therefore, here I have a message to our lovely Prime Minister, Mr. Keir Starmer, to the lawmakers of our land, to the authorities, the judiciary, the police, the other people in charge of various different things in our nation, like the teachers, the prison officials and so on. We have, my dear friends, serious issues in our nation. Of course, as you could see, we have turned our backs to Jesus Christ a long time ago. And that hasn't done us really good. Because we have turned our backs to Jesus many centuries ago, today we have got to a place where Islam is trying to get into our land. Islam is trying to gain a foothold in our land. And we have an urgent problem to deal with, my dear friends. The urgent problem is we need to get Islam banned. And it's high time we get Islam banned. So to the Prime Minister, to the MPs, the lawmakers, may I please bring this very important message. Have we banned Islam yet? If we haven't, why haven't we? It's unbelievable that we haven't had Islam banned yet. It's incredible. I mean, you just need to learn or read the Quran for 2 hours for you to figure out that Islam is doing no good to our land. Let me give you two broad areas of problems because of Islam.
On the record, can you state why you're here? Can you tell these people why you're here? And do you hate the Muslims?
That's a good point. The good question to ask. I am a Christian. I follow my wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ, my Lord and my Savior. As a Christian, I've learned to love even those who consider me to be their enemies. Love even at the cost of laying down my own life. I have been asked to love. I've been trained to love. And my Lord Jesus Christ is the best example at love. He said, greater love has no man than to lay down his life for his friend. So I've learnt from my precious Lord Jesus Christ that I am supposed to love not just Christians, but I'm also supposed to love every other non-Christian, including Muslims. Muslims are precious as human beings. Human beings are precious. And therefore, one second. Human beings are precious. And therefore, as my precious Lord Jesus Christ has commanded me, I have been asked and I will obey my Lord Jesus Christ in loving my Muslim friends even to the point of death. Human beings are not my problem. Human beings are not the problem of our nation. What is a problem to our nation is the ideology. The ideology of Islam is manic. You only have to read through the Quran for a while to find out that Islam is completely against, utterly against women. Half of our nation, half the population of our world have been discredited, have been demeaned, have been rejected, have been demoralized, have been removed identity by this ideology, this evil ideology called Islam. To an extent, today, if you consider what Islam does to women, don't look at what is happening here. Because here, clearly, Sharia isn't in full force. Look at what is happening in nations where Islam rules, my dear friends. So one broad area of problem. Lovely Prime Minister, Mr. Keir Starmer, this is a serious issue that you have to take into account. Are you planning to allow an ideology that demeans, that disrespects, and that objectivizes and removes the identity of half of our population?
Yes, he is.
Of half of our population. You would be held accountable. The Prime Minister, various ministers, various other lawmakers, all of you would be held accountable for this evil ideology taking root in our nation. And therefore, my dear friends, please wake up, and as Christians, we will cry out from every street corner, from speaker's corner, and from everywhere else in our nation, until this evil ideology has been removed utterly in our nation. So that's one major problem. Women, ill treatment of women by Islam is one major issue. There is another major issue. Islam does not just hate half of our population. That's not where it stops. Islam hates, violently hates all non-Muslims, men or women in our nation. My dear friends, what does the Quran, this book that I hold in my hand, what does it teach in relation to non-Muslims, in relation to Jews, in relation to Christians, and in relation to other non-Muslims? What does this book teach? Well, first of all, mildest of the teachings of this book in relation to all those who I've just mentioned, Jews, Christians, and other non-Muslims. Number one, it clearly instructs the Muslims never to be friends. Never to be friends with any of us. So as a Christian, I have been ostracized by Islam in relation to everyone who takes this book seriously. So number one, Islam, Quran asks Muslims to never take a Christian or a Jew or any other non-Christian or non-Muslim as a friend ever. Ever. We were never supposed to be taken as friends. Problem number one. It doesn't stop there. It goes beyond that. It demeans me, dehumanizes me. And the shameless Muslims here will never care to listen. While I am speaking, these parrots, shameless Muslims, will not take into account the problems that I am raising. How does Islam demean me as a Christian? How does Islam demean the Jews, Christians, and non-Muslims? Well, the Quran takes every opportunity to call each one of us pigs, apes, worst of creatures, and anything of this like. My dear friends, according to a Muslim who reads the Quran, if he has read the Quran for maybe five times in his life, he gets to understand that Christians are pigs, apes, worst of creatures. Pigs, apes, and the worst of creatures. So the Quran is a manual of dehumanizing the Jews, the Christians, and non-Muslims. It does not stop there either. Let me quickly get to the remaining points. My dear Prime Minister, Islam, number one, makes Muslims not be friends with me. And so no wonder you have Islamic ghettos, You have people who don't ever learn our culture. Number two, it dehumanizes. So no wonder you have Allahu Akbar shouts every now and then, going around killing people in the streets of our nation. And therefore, time to wake up. It does not stop there either. It goes on and tells Muslims, or gives instructions to Muslims, precisely as to what should happen beyond that. The Quran instructs Muslims to dispossess the Jews, the Christians, and the non-Muslims of every property that we have. What did the Islamic State do? The Islamic State followed the Quran verbatim. When they chased people from Mosul, what did they do? They followed the Quran. And therefore, dear friends, so Islam instructs
by monsters who only use religion as a way to demonstrate hatred.
Are you someone who is knowledgeable in the Quran, sir?
Keep your conversation.
Clueless people trying to educate. This is what happens. My dear friends. Good. So, dispossess Christians, Jews, and other non-Muslims of our properties. If you are wondering why this hasn't happened yet in our nation, to Christians, purely because the gentlemen here haven't got the opportunity. They are waiting desperately for Sharia laws implementation. They are waiting desperately for al-Baghdadi to show up in our nation. When al-Baghdadi shows up in our nation, what would this gentleman do? The gentleman who merely uses his mouth today will begin using other things at his disposal. It is time to wake up, my dear friends. Dispossession of property, third problem. It does not stop there. The Quran instructs Muslims, any faithful Muslim, to threaten, to curse, to fight, to kill, and to exterminate. Exterminate every Jew, every Christian, and every non-Muslim from our land. These Mickey Mouse Muslims, when al-Baghdadi shows up, they will suddenly become the lions. Today, they are Mickey Mouses or Mickey Mice. The reason that they are Mickey Mice today is not because they care about the law of the land, not because of that, but because they are aware if they try anything today, it simply will not work. And therefore, my dear friends, don't look at these people and think these are Mickey Mice. What could they do to us? Time is ticking. My dear friends, time. Can you see what is happening here? Muslims are clueless, who cannot employ their brains for themselves. And therefore, when al-Baghdadi says, go kill, these gentlemen would say, yes, boss, and will do that. And so, my dear friends, it's time to wake up before it is too late. It is time to wake up. We have always learnt from our precious Lord Jesus Christ. What have we learnt from our precious Lord Jesus Christ? We have learnt to love non-Christians, to serve non-Christians, to treat non-Christians equal to us, to serve non-Christians. What does the Lord Jesus Christ teach? The Lord Jesus Christ teaches us, bless those who curse you, pray for those who persecute you. And therefore, my dear friends, we as Christians will always try and help our Muslim friends, our Muslim neighbors. But the ideology is dangerous. And therefore, it is time for us all to wake up before it is too late. It is time for us to wake up. The Prime Minister of our nation, the other lawmakers, including all the ministers, may I please bring to you a very simple message. And the message is, do not pretend you know Islam. Please don't. If you want to learn Islam and take informed policy choices, please learn. Learn first. Don't hurry into conclusions. Learn first. Despite billions at your disposal, from what we can see, you haven't taken the trouble to learn the Quran. But we, without any public money, have learnt the Quran. So please get help from us. We are willing to give free advice to the government if you need. We can explain to you what the Quran teaches. Back to back, cover to cover, we can explain to you what the Quran teaches. Mr. Keir Starmer and all the rest of the ministers and MPs, please, time to learn. We have had too many terrorist attacks. Please do not think the nation is a nation of fools. Please do not think that you can get away every single time by not getting to the root of the problem. The root of the problem is what I hold in my hand, my dear friends. The root of the problem is, in relation to Islam, what I hold in my hand. Read it in Arabic, read it in English, read it in French, read it in German, read it in any other language. Read it front to back, read it back to front, read it top to bottom, bottom to top. The message is the same violent message. And therefore, it's time to ban Islam from hence. From this time forward, we as Christians will always bring the same reminder. Have we banned Islam yet? It is too late already, my dear friends. Muslims, it's a humble request to all of you. Even though your Quran has taught you, has indoctrinated to you to lie, to scheme, to act against us. Wake up! Leave Islam! Dear Muslim friends, you are all lovely as fellow human beings. But it is time to leave a violent religion. It is time to leave a violent doctrine. Leave Islam. Come and follow the precious Lord Jesus Christ. High time Muslims have ceased to be Muslims. It's high time. So my dear Muslim friends, time to wake up. And it's time to ban the religion. Because this is fit for no use and it is a ticking time bomb. Wake up before it is too late.